difference is second. World with a difference is amazing. Imagine if Paris was as good as Netherlands, looked as similar as Bangalore. I mean, this is my first time in Bangalore, and this feels like home, literally. So this is thank you for the to the IIS team, to Bangalore for the city it is, and to the warm welcome. Good morning, everyone. My name is Kalyani Khona. I've come from Delhi. I live in Delhi right now, but I am from Mumbai. I've lived in Brazil. I've lived in Cambodia. I've lived in different places, but difference is what made me go to those places is what I'm trying to tell you. So if I was like you and you were like me and we looked alike, world would be so much more boring and I wouldn't want to do anything except stay in my own house. So let's appreciate that today. This is a perfect platform to appreciate differences and accept them because that makes world challenging and worth living. So without any further ado, this is a very one statistic that I use for all the investors, but because they are into numbers, but this is much more than a statistic. This is a need that's not being met. So there are a lot of people, I've been in this event since yesterday, there are people who've spoken about education, who've spoken about charity, who've spoken about empowerment, and so on and so forth. It all comes from a social need being met, which is social need of acceptance, which comes when you find your better half or people you can be companion with, which was missing. Which was missing not just in India, so don't just blame India or the infrastructure. It's missing in USA, it's missing in Australia, it's missing. There's no boutique matchmaking agency or service across the globe which caters to people with disability. So let's stop comparing anyone with any country, with any state, whatever it is. So let's go a little behind on how you know, things happen. This is, I've been like listening to all the speakers and connecting to them because they said one thing that led to what they have done or they've been here was accidents. Accidents are the best things to happen. And accident did not be a negative word. I don't know why people make it so negative. It can change you and make you powerful in the most positive way you can ever envision. So accidents that change us, make us. Because I've met so many people who, if not that accident, I would have never been interested in knowing them, or I would have never been interested in getting to, you know, speak to them. So accidents that changes make us. Nobody from my maternal or paternal family had anything to do with any kind of disability. I had no idea. IIT, IIM, any of the premium colleges puts nothing in the curriculum. I am from HR College in Bombay, one of the premium institutes in Bombay teaching finance. I've majored in finance. Never ever brought, that seed has never been incepted in my mind, right? So let's also stop blaming the youth or not doing anything. By accident and by luck, I came across, you know, this whole thought that what do they do in their, you know, free time, or what do people with disability find interesting, or what are their entertainment options? And I started looking and the answer was nothing. So that's where my story starts, actually. That I was nothing before this. That's where I'm telling you that a world with difference starts with accidents. We are all stories in the end. So today, it's just about my story. My theme of this whole story would be to say you're going to be okay, and in the end, we all are going to be okay, and the world is not going to be going anywhere wrong. It's just the media putting it in our heads. But in the end, we're all going to be okay. So I'm 22. Three times life taught me you're going to be okay. First is in 2013, I went to Brazil. People there speak Portuguese, and less than 5% population speaks English. And I was 20 by then. And I had just graduated from a very Gujarati conservative family. We're going to Shimla Manali was also a big deal. And I said, I'm going to Brazil and alone. And my parents are like, are you sure today is your convocation? You should be looking for a job. I was like, no, that I'll figure. I'm going to be okay. So they let me go. I went there. I learned Spanish and Portuguese. FIFA was happening, so the crime rate was really high. I was literally put a gun here and my passport and everything was taken away. Story for another time. But all I'm saying is, I felt disabled there because I didn't speak their language. And that environment was new to me. And I never knew anybody there. I had no friends there. I went alone in a very unknown place. Until then, also, it didn't strike me that, okay, what about people with disability in India? But that was my first encounter. Looking back today when I was in my room making this PPT, I was like, yeah, disability was there. And I was there. I was a part of it and I never realized it. So that was my first incident, which taught me that it's all right to understand and know. It is all right to not understand or not know everything or anything at all. And you're still going to be okay because I didn't speak their language. I didn't know the maps. I didn't know the place. I didn't know who to go to. I had very limited money. I was bootstrapping. I've never taken money from my parents after 17. So it was a new environment, bootstrapping everything. And here you go. You are, which is why bringing just as a side note, my company is still bootstrapped because I've learned best challenges and learning lessons come when nobody's feeding you money. You know, you need to make your own money, earn, spend, and that's when you understand how challenging and interesting life can be. So I was okay. In 2014, I started Wanted Umbrella. It's a boutique agency for people with disability. I saw a gap and I said, let me just do a project. I don't want to start a company and all. I was unsure what I wanted to do. My parents used to, my brother's getting married in 6 months and my parents used to be like, let her first get a real job and then we'll see what she can do. So it was that as a case. I started and Bangalore, in fact, the New Indian Express in Bangalore was the first one to write about Wanted Umbrella, which gave me 100 profiles for next 3 months where I could, you know, understand what goes into matchmaking for people with disability. There were times when people called and said, I have albinism. Do you think I can get married? I was like, hang on, Google. What is albinism? So it was. I was coming from there, you know, and no medical background or nothing. So, but I said these 100 people were the ones I started writing to, saying, you help me understand this. You help me find, because you understand your problem the best. I'll just be the coordinator. It's as simple. Entrepreneurship is really simple. You just need to ask people what to do and just do it. It's okay. You're going to be okay with it. So I started this and, you know, 100, 150, 200. I was like, I can't take more than 200 because manually I can't remember 200 people, their preferences, their disability, their medical condition, their level of independence, their cure, and so on and so forth. So I went to somebody, he's the founder of Citrus Pay, which is just like Paytm. And I said, what is the solution to this? Either I stop my shop or I'm going to burn out or I will only be able to impact 100 people. Which is also fine because at 22, impacting one person was also a big deal for me. So he said, no, you need to give more power to the users. You're feeling trapped because you don't know technology. I was disabled at technology. Technology was not my thing. I'm a finance major. And he said, you're scared right now. You think you're not going to be okay because you don't know how to use technology. He said, make a dating app. I was like, dating app? I don't know how to go about the whole thing. And it started as that thought, of course. I had no money for it. So going next, I knew that with zero funds, zero experience or support, because I didn't, when yesterday I came, I knew people here, but otherwise when I started, I didn't know anybody in this sector. And they told me, you're gonna be okay. And yeah, I'm okay. So going to my next incident, in 2015, I introduced Lovability. And I did not have money for this. And like I said, I think that screen's blocking the thing. But it says 6,15,000 lakhs raised by 143 backers. So basically, the concept of crowdfunding is just like Karma Kitchen, which we were with yesterday. You can give whatever amount you want, from 1,000 rupees to 10,000 to 5,000 to 50,000. And depending on that, I said, people, if you give me 10,000, I'm going to get you a date. And if you give me 50,000, I'm going to send you a cookie jar at your house with 1,000 messages for every day of your next 1,000 days. Do something like, I'm going to publish you in the magazine, so on and so forth. So nothing in return, which was money or equity. And when somebody first told me you can do that, I was like, what? People give money without anything in return? And they're like, yeah, people do that. And I was like, okay, let's try and let's see how that goes. We raised 15 lakhs in 40 days. And it's been an amazing ride because just not crowdsourcing, but we got to know people in general are really generous and good people. Like I'm trying to tell you, it's all media driven. Because negative sells, negative connects sometimes, but positive is what prevails. So that's how the whole thing started. We started making the app. This is the Wishberry team which helped me raise 1,15,000 from 143 backers from USA to Brazil, to Colombia. My graphic designer is Colombian right now, and I feel really disabled explaining how to boil milk. So that's how I've been coming through disability every day of my life. It's just mine is not visible because it's here. And some of time it's visible because it's here. That's the only difference. So that's how my second story happened. And so I realized, third story happened. So I realized that, in this crowdsourcing, we made sure we don't use disability. We said we will just raise 6 lakhs on the concept of love. We'll say we want to make people fall in love. They don't have equal opportunities like you and you have. So give us money and we're going to make them fall in love. And people paid. They didn't know what disabilities, they didn't know what autism is, they didn't know what albinism is. They said, oh, we want to give money for love. So I knew that to be okay for the next 10 years and continue doing this, I have to create more love. Because love was selling, right? Love was working for me. So this is lovability. I'm introducing this for the first time, in fact. This is an actual client of mine, Ashish Lamba from Ahmedabad. And he's been to the websites, to the matrimonial sites, and things have not worked for him, just like Deepa's experience was. But hers was overwhelming. His was, on the other side, where he was the one requesting Deepa to connect, but it was not working out. So this is how it is. You have about me. You have lifestyle, which is work preferences, what do you guys like to do, hobbies, interests, because it doesn't need to be only about disability when it's matchmaking. It also has, it also has information like medical condition, medication, possibility of cure, level of independence, instruments, so that I know if I want to go out on a date with somebody, I know what kind of expectation setting I want to have. Because matrimony or matchmaking, more than love, which is like the first step, second is the right expectation setting from your partner, which is why most, not disabled, any marriages break when they don't have the right expectation setting. So having a right expectation setting right from the first screen is so much more easier, makes time much more efficient. And you value the other person for the honesty that has been delivered to you. So we just don't have people with disability, but without disability, because my point was, I went on a date with somebody on a wheelchair and I had the best date of my life. So I knew that I want to be on this app, but my friends said, we also want to be on this app, and what is wrong with you? Why are you creating this, just for them? And I was like, I always thought they had their separate preferences. Of course, I'm coming from a background of learning, so nobody throws tomatoes here, okay? But I'm saying they wanted a separate preference, and our preferences are separate. We like to go out every day, hang out. I'm not sure. And I said, let's do a social experiment. My life has been just social experiments. So I was like, let's do another one, and let's see. And we started having 35 matches, profiles on, these are actual profiles, on this app. And it was interesting. Ishita was connecting to somebody. She's in USA right now. She was connecting to a profile in US, and she went and met. And she's like, oh, I had an amazing experience. And he was hearing impaired, but that made a date so much more memorable. I had to literally learn and understand and see. It was a change. It was a breath of fresh air. I'm coming from the other side. It's boring to just go on a coffee and come back home and then just get back to texting. It's so much more challenging, interesting, awesome if I have to make efforts to make that date work, So... It worked out that way. A lot of my team is just 3 people in 20s, actually below 25. And this is our accessibility setting. If you'll see, we have a bottom bar just as a 1 minute so that anyone who wants to make an app knows it's just that simple. Coming from nowhere, I got through here. So it's a bottom bar. We have if you have retina disorder, we have different previews that you can do. You can change the themes of the mobile app through your color contrast options, and that session gets saved. Also, this is 100% accessible to screen readers for visually impaired individuals. We've tested this a lot of times. Our next phase, which is just pending, is the voice commands, which will only, we know we're missing out on that particular target group, but in 6 lakhs, this is what we could make right now. We need to channelize more funds to go to the next step. We did a beta testing. Here are quick results. Beta is basically you release it to only a very private group of your target audience and what they have to say about the app. 99% said it's accessible. The 1% is actually the voice commands that's missing. 93% testers said they will download the app on public release. 7.5 on 10 in beta. So beta is not the perfect version. It's like if you see Twitter 10 years back or 5 years back, just the bar and the basic thing. Yet they wanted to download the app because there's nothing that exists. It's not my app. It's nothing that exists for them. So they're going to do it. 54% testers said they want to use Lovability to meet new people, while 30 said they want to use this for matrimony. The last statistics shook me because that means there's a bigger challenge to target, not just matchmaking. It's of course started with that, but I have to go make sure platforms like this happen every day in India at different cities and locations. So it needs to go beyond Bangalore. We've done something called social spaces in Delhi, where we've got people with disability, without disability. It's an inclusive small space of 10 people. And we said, what books do you like? What do you like to read? And there is one person who's helping a visually impaired girl convert few favorite books to audio. And they're almost going to fall in love, I'm saying. So that's how it's there. So I know a lot of you guys have dreams here, a lot of accidents that have led you to ideas that you want to do something about it. We are going to be okay. We should just do it, is what I'm trying to say. And that's where my last thought is. I want to impact 200 million lives across the globe at the age of 22 with limited funds. And if I'm going to be okay, definitely go ahead, do whatever you guys want. You're going to be okay. Please call me and I'll help you out with it. So this is my contact details because I'm going to take my flight very soon. But so take that first step. That's my team. We even have our caretaker, our maid, in the team picture because she's a part of this. She takes care of us so that we can make the product and we can focus. So everyone's included in my team. Nobody's excluded. And that's the message I want to drive. So take that first step. You will always be okay. Thank you.
When he was talking, something was running in my mind. Right? Yeah. So, what is happening in my mind? So, have you ever imagined people from Tinder, OKCupid?